We got a penalty behind the play. And I'm looking here. The referee blew the whistle.
I don't know, Mike, but I think Danny is with a special guest.
I apologize. Danny, go ahead.
All right, guys, thank you very much. Yes, a very, very special guest. NHL Hall of Famer Jean Beliveau. Very much involved with this organization still after so many years. I know you won 10 Stanley Cups as a player, another 7 within management, but you dropped the opening puck tonight. Why is it so important for you to stay involved with this organization?
Well, I think I'm a very fortunate man to still be after, almost 55 years. Being part of this organization. I love the game, and it's certainly nice to see the new game. Certainly I agree 100% that every infraction involving the stick should be penalized.
And speaking about the new game, I want to ask you about one of our newest players. Your impression of Sidney Crosby.
Usually a youngster, especially 18 or 19 years old, it takes a year or two before you get adjusted to the speed of this game, but him, he has everything. Natural talent, great ability. He looked physically strong. And I'm always happy when there's a youngster coming up like that. It's good for the game.
And while we were talking about that, he just lit the lamp again.
Well, I missed this one, but I look at the replay.
Hey, real quickly, I want to ask you really quickly about the number that you chose to wear, number 4. Not a lot of offensive players wore number 4. You don't see it now. You didn't see it much back then.
When I came up in 1953 for good after signing my first contract, and they say here number 4 is available. There were 3, 4 or 5 numbers available. I pick up 4. No special reason.
Well, I'm sure you're number 4, but you're number 1 to a lot of these fans. John, thank you so much for the time.
Thank you very much, Dan. I did the opening game in Pittsburgh.
Oh.
I did the opening face-off, and they had the penguin on the ice.
Really?
I'm never going to forget that. And thank you for giving me the time to say hello to many great hockey fans in Pittsburgh.
Okay. Hey, Mike, back up to you. How about that?
Wow.
True class.
What an ambassador for the game this guy is.
Remembers the face-off, and I think the Canadiens won that game 2-1, the first game ever played. They're going to take another look at this apparent go-ahead goal by the Penguins as Sidney Crosby had to come off of him.
Off his skate, they're going to see if it was kicked in. Watch the right skate of Sidney Crosby, and you be the judge. Was there a subtle movement of the right skate? There could have been. You can change the direction of the puck with your skate. It can go off your skate. You can redirect a puck, angle a puck, but you cannot use a skate. You can't use a kicking motion with the right skate. And his skate was going towards the net. Was it a natural motion or was it a kicking motion? Oh boy, this is a very tough call. A very tough call. It was called a goal on the ice. And it has to be conclusive upstairs. And they're taking a long look. His skate was going towards the net, Mike, but that was the direction that he was going. Was there a subtle movement with his right skate? You could say there is. You could deem there is. I don't think so. I think he's going to get, I just don't know how you're going to call it. It's one man or two man's.
I don't think it's a distinct
perception.
Kicking motion. It is going to be credited to the Penguins.
Yep.
Not a distinct kicking motion.
Kicking
that
motion.
That's
it,
how they describe it.
Good call.
Crosby will get the goal at 1:58, his second of the night, 21st of the year, and Pittsburgh has the lead once again.